So I got this great question from one of you guys recently inside of our e-commerce Empire Builders Facebook group asking, which is better, Pete? Should we be using Zipify in our Shopify stores, or should we be using ClickFunnels for our e-commerce and dropshipping businesses? Well, in today's video, we're gonna be covering that exactly and what you need to know. Should you be using Zipify, or should you be using ClickFunnels for your dropshipping business? Now, if you're tuning in for the e-commerce Empire Builders for the very first time, I wanna give you a huge welcome. Every single Monday, Wednesday, Friday, we release new content here and we do a giveaway at the same time. Today's giveaway winner is gonna get our e-commerce Empire Starter Pack course completely for free. If you wanna enter this giveaway, all you gotta do is drop a comment down below on today's video, make sure you're subscribed, and most importantly, you need to turn that notification bell on so you can tune into the next video to see if you won the free course. So make sure you're paying attention to this whole video to see if you're that lucky giveaway from the last video. All right, guys, so we're gonna quickly cover some stuff on the whiteboard visually, and then we're gonna go on the computer screen so I can kind of walk you through some of these things. So the first thing I wanna talk about is Zipify and the benefits of Zipify and the benefits of ClickFunnels, okay? So here's the thing. This is how typically a Zipify works. Now, Zipify stands for one-click upsell. It's an application that you can install into your Shopify storefronts that allows you to upsell your customers. Okay, now here's how a Zipify kind of funnel looks like, right? You're still sending people to your product pages on Shopify, right? Your traffic, Facebook, influencers, however you're doing it. But this is where the change happens, right? When they purchase, right? Now we're gonna skip over a couple pages here, like cart pages and stuff like that. But once they check out and actually put in their billing information, right? What Zipify allows you to do is have one-click upsells, right? Meaning that they click a button and they get automatically billed their credit card, okay? This is very, very powerful, right? Having one-click upsells like this is so important, especially for your Shopify store. And really the best app to do this is going to be Zipify. Now, again, these are after they've completed their first initial order, and then you can bill them automatically. They'll have an option to put yes or no. Now, Zipify, you can have upsells, you can also have downsells, right? So let's say you're charging something here for, you know, you're giving them, you know, two for a dollar, they say no, you give them here for three for a dollar, or whatever the offer is, right? So you can downsell them that, right? And you can also have multiple upsells, as many upsells as you want before they finally hit their thank you page. Now, this is typically what a Zipify funnel looks like, and it is really critical to have this in any sort of Shopify store. And the reason for this is because you need to be able to maximize the amount of money somebody spends with you when they come through your business. Okay, this is how you increase your average cart value. This is how you increase your lifetime value of your customer. Now, I know what you might be thinking. Well, then how does ClickFunnels fit into this? Why would I need ClickFunnels if I can just use Zipify in my Shopify store? That's what we're gonna cover next. So this is how a typical ClickFunnels funnel now looks like. Now, it probably looks really, really similar to what you're seeing on the Shopify funnel. However, the results are ridiculously different, okay? So when your traffic is sending on a ClickFunnels page, you're not sending it to a Shopify store, you're sending it to a ClickFunnels landing page, as you're gonna see in a minute here when we go over the shoulder. Okay, now you're sending people to something called an opt-in page. Now this opt-in page, the sole purpose of this page is to collect the email address of your customer. Okay, this creates an asset for your business. You can follow up with this person with future promotions, right? You can do abandoned cart emails. You can do, you know, the money is in the list, okay? So once you grab that email address, then they're presented the opportunity to actually purchase from you. Now there's a ton of cool hacks on the checkout pages like order bumps, quantity break discounts. We're not gonna cover all of that in today's video, but just know that there's a lot of checkout hacks that you can do in a ClickFunnels page that you cannot do in a Shopify store. Now after they actually check out right here, okay, what happens next is you can have the pretty much the same upsell sequence that you have on your with your Zipify, okay? Now upsell one, you can have a downsell two, you can have upsell two, you can have as many upsells as you want. And the key here that you can really have inside of a ClickFunnels page is the one-click recurring revenue upsell, right? So think BarkBox, Dollar Shave Club, right? Where you can automatically start billing your customers on a monthly repeatable basis, right? This comes all by default within ClickFunnels. And as you're gonna see in a minute, why I prefer ClickFunnels over, you know, Shopify Shopify in general and Zipify is because you get a lot of stuff just right out of the box for one price from ClickFunnels, when Zipify can really cost you an arm and a leg. However, I do want to stress, if you are somebody that already has a Shopify store, right, my recommendation is to put Zipify in it, right? So you're maximizing the people that come to your Shopify store and purchase from you, but then also have a ClickFunnels page as well where you're driving all your cold traffic, all right? This is how you should be acquiring all your customers. Then you could send your customers to a Shopify store from your emails, your existing customers, your list, whatever, but all customers that are coming from ads, influencers, wherever, they should be coming from a ClickFunnels page because it lets you generate assets, it lets you increase your average cart value as well as your lifetime value with the monthly subscriptions. So we're gonna go over the shoulder right now, and I'm gonna show you all of this within a computer screen, but I did quickly wanna mention, if you do use any of the affiliate links for Zipify or ClickFunnels that you'll see in the description of today's video, email Peter at ecommerceempirebuilders.com. We have a ton of free bonuses to help you build your e-commerce empire, and as a way of saying thank you for supporting the channel, okay? So those links will be down below. We'll give you a bunch of eight-figure funnel templates, a bunch of email sequences that you can start using for your business. So again, those links will be down below in the description of this video, but let's get back into it, guys. So we're first gonna talk about Zipify one-click upsell. Now, there are some changes that are happening with Zipify one-click upsell. There is a wait list to get on it now. Maybe by the time you're watching this video, it will be open. It looks like they're doing some changes internally. If you're still using it, it's completely fine, but you know, once they open up the wait list, they're integrating better with the Shopify checkout. But this is what Zipify really allows you to do. Zipify allows you to create pages like the one you're seeing on your screen that just allows you simple one-click upsell pages. So after somebody checks out on your product page that you're selling on Shopify, you can customize pages like this where you're saying, hey, wait, one limited, limited time special offer, the perfect complement to your order. Like for example, this is, you know, selling a phone for $399. Now, when somebody clicks to add to my order, they automatically get billed for this, okay? There is no like cart pages or anything like this with Zipify or ClickFunnels. They get automatically billed for their credit card, or they can say, no thanks, I'll pass that, and they'll go to the next step in the funnel, the next upsell, until they hit the thank you page. Now, here's the thing about Zipify and why I don't necessarily like it as much as ClickFunnels. And the reason for that is because Zipify charges you a monthly fee to use it, right? So $50 a month, plus it also takes a percentage of all the sales it makes you, which in my opinion, I don't really like that. I know they're maximizing the money that they can make for their business, for Zipify's business, but it's not in your best interest to give up, you know, 2-3% of your sales that they make you to just give it to them, okay? And that's one of the biggest reasons that I don't like Zipify. I would still recommend it for people that just have a Shopify store to make a little bit of money. It's worth it. But for somebody just starting out, that kind of money can add up, right? Especially if you're pushing a lot of volume through it. But trust me, you know, I get it. They have to make as much money as they can as well. But that's why I really prefer ClickFunnels, because right out of the box, you have all of these features and they don't charge you a percentage of your sales. So you might be somebody that's like, oh man, ClickFunnels costs $97 a month. Man, it's so expensive, but it's the only tool you need, right? If you're trying to build a funnel with Shopify, it's gonna cost you $400 or $500, if not more, and you can't even do all the things Shopify that you can do with a ClickFunnels page, okay? So let me bring up a template that we have here on the channel. You can actually download this template completely for free. It'll be in the description of this video. If you do end up downloading Zipify or ClickFunnels, make sure you email Peter at ecommerceempirebuilders.com. We have a ton of free bonuses to give you to help you build your e-commerce empire. But here's what a ClickFunnels page looks like, okay? So this is that landing page, that opt-in page that I was referring to, okay? Let's load that up. Now, this page, the sole purpose of this page right here is to grab that email address, right? This is an asset. This is what you miss out on if you're just using Zipify and not using a funnel to generate those leads, right? This is a very simple looking page, and it's like that for a reason. It's not like a Shopify store that has a ton of bells and whistles, tons of products, tons of distractions, right? You can see on this page, there's really nowhere else for the person to go, right? We're highlighting one specific offer and that's it. And this is why, guys, you'll see on a Shopify store, average conversion rates on Shopify are like 1-2% max, right? Average conversion rates on a funnel though are 10+%, right? 7-10%, you know, regularly, right? So that can really 10x your business by just using a funnel and just simplifying things. Trust me, I get it. I know it's fun adding more products to your store and you think like you're working, but in actuality, are you doing the right things? Are you pulling those right levers that are gonna make your business the most amount of money? And most people aren't, right? They're focused on adding more products and this and that and more apps and thinking that's gonna save them. them. When it's not, you focus on one specific offer with one specific funnel. So right here, you could see, you know, we're just, the whole purpose of this page is just to highlight the amazingness of this one specific offer and get them to say, yes, raise my hand, and they raise their hand by entering in their email address. Now, after they do that, now they hit the order form. You could see how simple this page is. Guys, what, this is like six pages, right? I mean, I like to keep things simple, especially for anybody that we build funnels for, right? Like, why am I gonna complicate your life so much with a ton of different apps that you have to pay for, right? So here's the thing, here's the order form. After they opt in here, they hit the order form page. Now this order form page, super simple, right? Now here are a couple order form hacks that you can put in here. Always have quantity break discounts. You can see we have 1, 2, 4 options here, right? Giving them a better and better deal as they buy more than one. We also can have order bumps here. Now this order bump is a pre-purchase upsell. It's not a post-purchase upsell like Zipify or the upsells we were looking at from ClickFunnels and Zipify, right? This is a pre-purchase upsell, and you wanna use these sparingly. Only one order bump, right? I know you can have like multiple order bumps, just one, keep it simple. Now this can be digital products. It could be information, you know, information products like this one is, a phishing master guide. It could be, you know, expedited shipping. It could be a warranty. It could be a gift. It could be anything. I love to think of an order bump as a no-brainer. If you can't write it out in, you know, 2-3 sentences what the order bump is and you need pictures to explain it, you're trying too hard, right? The order bump is very simple, no pictures. It should be able to be explained in, you know, a sentence or two, and it should be a very, very complimentary product that is just a no-brainer for them to buy. Think of it like being at a grocery store checkout line, right? Last minute, you just grab, you know, a bag of chips or whatever it is, a pack of gum, right? That's how simple an order bump should be. All right, guys, I hope you're enjoying today's video so far. We're gonna quickly flash our last giveaway winner right there. If that is you, email peter@ecommerceempirebuilders.com. And don't forget, if you wanna win our e-commerce empire starter pack course completely for free, all you have to do is drop a comment down below on today's video, hit the subscribe button, and most importantly, hit that notification bell as well so you can tune into the next one to see if you won the free course. Now, these two hacks right here will typically make you already more than what a Shopify store will get you, okay? And then after they buy here, then you could send them to those one-click upsells. So you can see here we have 3 one-click upsells, and you can have as many as you want. There is no right or wrong. I typically now recommend, just to get a funnel out there, I recommend 3 upsells, okay? Now, those 3 upsells are critical to get right, right? Upsell number 1 and number 2, as you're gonna see here, we're just selling them more of the same exact thing that they just bought at a discounted rate, right? And if they click yes, add, or no, thank you, right? They can click yes to buy it, or no, thank you. Now, here's the thing. I wanna kinda dive into what your upsell should be, and you really wanna focus on a few things to test out here. To start, sell more of in your upsells of what they just bought, right? They raise their hand, they told you, hey, I bought fishing lures, right? Sell them more fishing lures, right? Do not complicate this, right? Don't go and try and sell them fishing rods after they just told you, I just want fishing lures, right? Give yourself the best shot at winning. You wanna have a lot of people converting on these upsells so you're maximizing the profits of your business, okay? So start by first selling more of the same thing, right? If you try selling more of the same thing and your upsells aren't converting as the way you thought they would be, right? The next thing to test out is going to Amazon and looking at the frequently bought together items of your main product, right? After that, try those frequently bought together, right? Amazon's telling you that data, right? What are people buying with these fishing lures? Sell those products, okay, that are frequently bought together. Those are the first things that I would test in any single funnel that we launch, is just give yourself the best shot at winning. A lot of you try different things and try and reinvent the wheel when the data is already out there telling you what you should already be testing, okay? So keep things simple for yourself. With your upsells, test selling more of the same thing, and if that doesn't work for you, sell complementary products that you see that are frequently bought together with your main product. And this goes for Zipify or ClickFunnels or whatever you're using, okay? Give yourself the best shot at winning, okay? Now, most important is you always wanna have a subscription page in here. Now, these subscription pages are gonna be upsell pages just like you're seeing here as well. And these pages, again, are one click. Think BarkBox, Dollar Shave Club, right? We have a bunch of content on the channel already around subscription. We'll leave it in like the corner of this video, one of the recent subscription videos that I talk about, and I show you how to actually set this up. So click that and watch it after you watch the rest of this video. But it's so important to have that subscription, guys. I can't stress it enough, right? That subscription page is what gets you paid on a monthly reoccurring basis. You can't do that one-click subscription with Zipify, right? Imagine 1 out of 10 buyers join your monthly subscription plan where you could bill them month after month, let's say $20, $30, right? That adds up. That is free sales. You're not paying for those ads anymore. That is free sales coming into your business every single month. I mean, it is literally the closest thing to free money that you can put into your business. It's putting in these upsells, putting in that subscription page as well. Again, if you do use the links for either Zipify or ClickFunnels down below in the description of today's video, please email peter@ecommerceempirebuilders.com. We have a ton of free bonuses, email sequences, 8-figure funnel templates, a bunch of stuff to help you build your e-commerce business. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, you know what to do. Smash that like button, hit the subscribe button if you already haven't, and don't forget to drop a comment down below to be entered in to win a free e-commerce empire starter pack course. And let me know your thoughts. What are you using right now? Zipify, ClickFunnels, a mixture of both like I suggested? Let me know down below in the comments section. Also, if you use any of the affiliate links down below in the description for either Zipify or ClickFunnels, email peter@ecommerceempirebuilders.com. We have a ton of free bonuses that we want to give you to help you build your e-commerce empire, including fully built website funnel templates, fully built email sequences that you can start using for your dropshipping business. Again, the links for Zipify and ClickFunnels will be down below in the description of today's video. Again, email us if you use any of those affiliate links, and we're going to shower you with a ton of free bonuses to help you build your e-commerce empire. Guys, as always, have a fantastic rest of your day. And remember, your empire starts now.